And I always say, at the end of the day, our goal and our mission, Magic's, Bird's, everybody's, is to win championships. Mm-hmm. That's it. I don't care how you get there. I don't care what you do to get there. I don't care if you got to pick up a team. I don't care what you do. It doesn't matter. The goal is to win.
Welcome to the Staples Center in Los Angeles. It's game four between the Lakers and the Phoenix Suns. Kobe Bryant and the seven-seeded Lakers leading the best of seven set. 2-1 with an impressive victory on their home floor Friday night. And the Phoenix Suns looking to even things up. They'd love to get it into Nash's hands, and they do. Ball knocked away, stolen by Parker.
Oh, there it is.
Here comes George to Kobe Bryant. Bryant inside. It's good. It's good. Tie game. Bryant with the save.
Oh, you got to get a shot here.
Final seconds. Bryant for the win.
Think about, and a lot of fans think about, is that big shot you hit against Spain.
Yeah. The shush three.
And you know, you've kind of made a career out of making and taking big shots and developed a reputation to do that. But what is it about just the last few seconds of a game on the line that just kind of brings the best out of you?
You just gotta have the fearlessness to really take those shots, you know, because you miss those shots, then you have to deal with the criticism you have to deal with. You know, a lot of times, a lot of people kind of get a little apprehensive about taking those shots because of that. It's always been a myth to me as to why certain people don't really like those situations because of the pressure. Because we've all lost games before. So it's not like by you missing that shot, you're about to face something that you will never face again or haven't faced in the past. You know what I mean? We've all come up short at, you know, one time or another. So you just got to kind of let it all hang out and, you know, trust your skills and trust the work that you've put in.
Thank you.
what Phil's diagram, but take us through that last sequence.
Well, I just had to get open at all costs because we had no more timeouts left. I caught the ball out a lot further than I would like. And what can I say? I just hit a lucky shot.
Look at his eyes. You know he wants the basketball and wants to take over this ball game.
Well, you see why Kobe Bryant's on this team. Money under pressure.
The Lakers for the win. Kobe going up over Bell. Fall away. Last chance time for the Lakers. Down by two, 108-106, and a break. And we have Gasol trying to find Kobe. And Kobe will get it to the win.
He is hard to believe.
No, he's not.
Yes!
He does it.
I'm just looking. Gets it to Bryant. Bryant dribbling. Has to put it up with the buzzer. Banks it in.
He always talked about this Mamba mentality. He didn't have to create that. It was already there. And to watch him search out information, to watch him want to find some way to get better every year. But I think the thing that resonates with me the most is his incredible career. This is a sad city right now. One person with one name, Kobe.
And after a 22-year absence, the Boston Celtics are NBA champions once again.
We lost to the Celtics in 08, and it was a physical series. I mean, they beat the crap out of us.
Yeah.
And so we go into the Olympic year that year. Yeah. We wound up playing Spain for the gold medal match, and we beat them.
Uh-huh.
And so now we come back to start training camp, and Powell shows up the first day of training camp. I have my gold medal hanging in his locker.
Oh, no.
And he, I mean, like, the one thing that he truly, truly loves is his country.
Of course.
Like, that is, like, everything to him. So it just drove him crazy. Oh, I said, Powell, listen, you lost to the Celtics. You lost to us in a gold medal match. Let's not make this three in a row this year.
Wow.
Okay?
That is
Let's
brilliant.
Win this thing. I think about 09, things started changing for
okay.
me. I started really making a conscious effort to better understand. And that doesn't mean you have compassion and empathy, so you go soft on them. It's more like you put yourself to the side, and you put yourself in their shoes and understand what they're feeling. And then you have to make certain decisions of, okay, what buttons do I need to push with this
yeah.
player to get them to the next level? So it's not sit around and it's all happy-go-lucky
right.
type of thing. Your leader, your job is to get the best out of them, even if they may not like it at that time.
The challenge is learning how to take a collection of guys that all have different personalities and different backgrounds and making sure everybody stays on the same page. I understood if I'm going to win championships, this is what I need to learn. And quite honestly, the challenge was thrust upon me on, when Shaq leaves, you can't win. So I said, oh, shit, yes I can. You know what I mean? So when that happened, it became my motivation. That became my passion, and I was obsessed with it, and here we go.
Remember back in the day when you taught me to live and I taught you to pray. We went in the battle together, no matter the weather, we never delayed. You gave me commands,
Bryant,
I always obeyed.
Bryant, tough shot, drills it. Bryant, it's inside. Oh, what a finish for Kobe Bryant. But the Lakers take game one.
Should not have let me get away, cause
Ryan with the score.
Pray I'm bigger, I'm better, my mind is a weapon. I will never let up. You try to break me down and I'ma just get up. They ask me how I did it.
Here's Kobe for the win. The Utah Jazz hold on.
Fight for my life.
What will the mindset be when you're back in L.A. Monday with a chance to close out the series?
Be a mature professional team. Try to handle our business.
The Lakers eliminate the Utah Jazz in five.
That'll seal a Houston Rocket win. As Kobe looks over at Doug Collins and said, this guy cannot guard me. Scooping, driving, and putting it in. How in the world did he do that?
Asking myself how we got here. Remember, this is who we are.
Was an impressive 14-point win here in Houston.
To me, in the playoffs, they're one and the same. I'm not, a big proponent of losing by 30 points, losing by 1 point, and what's the difference and all sorts of stuff. A loss is a loss. You know, it's not going to carry over to the next game.
The Lakers have gone up 3-2 over the Houston Rockets.
And the Houston Rockets, another tremendous performance at home. Game 7 coming up on Sunday.
I'm a survivor.
As they survive against the gritty, tough Houston Rockets team, and now advance to the Western Conference Finals.
Describe his game, what it's been like to play against him over the years.
Man, he's an assassin, man. And, you can't take no plays off, going up against him. You've seen, flashes of him out there. And, you still have that look in his eyes when he get the ball. And, you got to pay close attention to him. So we definitely gonna miss that.
Carmelo is like a brother to you. You're very close with him. Tonight, you went back and forth in a head-to-head battle. What was that like?
It was a lot of fun. He's a bull down there, so I'm a little out of my weight class, but I'll give him my best shot.
Terrific play from Carmelo Anthony. He is in a groove right now. Anthony on Bryant. Bryant for three. That's good. Hand in his face, knocks it down. Bryant and Anthony once again putting on show. And the Nuggets have tied the series at one game apiece.
You've had Michael Jordan, the best that's ever played. Now you have Kobe Bryant. Not that I want you to compare the two, just tell me if they have similar ways about them as professional basketball players.
Something that's an attribute that both of them have is that you could set the bar at 7.5 feet and tell them nobody's ever jumped that before, and they say, I can do it. And they'll go out and try it. Whether they can do it or not, they're still going to try and climb it.
Kobe Bryant knocks it down.
Hand down, man down.
Shot clock at 6. Bryant for 3. Puts it in. Kobe Bryant from downtown. And the Lakers regain the lead. Look at the determination on his face. The Lakers regain home court advantage. After the disappointing loss in Game 3, Nuggets bounce back.
Kobe Bryant, exactly how tired was he? Well, in his decade plus in this league, he said he has never felt that level of exhaustion, guys.
And the L.A. Lakers have taken a 3-2 lead in the series as it heads back to Denver.
I think I need you. You're playing desperation basketball. Hey, no mercy, man.
Bryant, tough shot. Knocks it down.
Blocked this shot.
The LA Lakers are Western Conference champions. They win the series in 6 games.
What do you take from what you've learned in each of these series that helps you win the finals?
Well, just gained valuable experience. It's been a physical march all the way back to the finals. Every series has been tough. And now we're back at a place where we didn't finish our business last year. Hopefully we'll do it this year.
We're talking to him. much tougher team. Tougher mentally, tougher physically.
We're my eyes on you, man. This is that Olympic thing, right?
Your expressiveness is like gone up another level. We know you've been a hard-driving leader for a long time. It seems like, you know, you really cut it loose now.
I just want it so bad, that's all. I just want it really bad. So, you know, it's just, you just put everything you have into the game, and then, you know, your emotions kind of flow out of it.
As we're set to go for game one of the 2009 NBA Finals. Falling away, tough shot, puts it in. Oh, what a shot from Kobe Bryant. Tough shot, that's good. You take a look at Kobe Bryant, certain times he just has that look. And right now, he understands it's business time. Oh, what a move from Kobe Bryant. Hit, counted, and one.
He's got that look, he's got that game.
Shot clock at two, he's got to put it up. Tries to bank it, does so, and a foul.
Get the idea that this guy is trying to make a statement in game one. My goodness.
Bryant again.
While talking, communicating, being a leader. Sometimes what you go through is transportation to where you're going to. Right now, Kobe Bryant is playing with a sense of urgency.
Paul.
Yo.
What's up, Greg?
You talk about a guy with one mindset, that's the win.
My energy was actually higher than it was the other night. But Orlando, they just executed extremely well. We're close, you see what I'm saying? This is the finals.
Tekulu pulls up, puts up, knocks it down, a two-pointer for Tekulu.
Lakers will have a shot to win game two.
They're facing the great closer, Kobe Bryant.
Bryant driving, Bryant blocked from behind by Tekulu. Alley-oop to Lee, won't go, and we go to overtime. Bryant looks inside, finds Gasol, counted, and a foul. The Lakers survive and win game two in overtime.
Bryant double team, knocks it down. Kobe Bryant, lethal early. Shot clock winding down and a foul, and it's good.
That's not enough fight right there. To the basket, throws it down.
Team trust me to come through in those situations, and it just didn't happen tonight. Just got to bounce back, be ready to go game four.
Your game face has been on the entire series. What's the story? Are you not happy, or you're only half happy, or?
Still to be happy about. Job's not finished. Job finished? No, I don't think so.
Yeah. Go ahead and smile, Kobe.
Kobe Bryant's scared. When he's on the floor, it's almost like, hey, it's okay. Everything's going to be all right, guys.
Drive, shot's good, out of foul.
During a championship run, you're going to have moments where you just make big plays.
Oh, my goodness. Kobe Bryant with Petrus all over.
The guys stepped up. I mean, Trevor made a big three. You know, Derek obviously made two big ones. But that's what it's about. That's what the journey's about. You got to have guys step up and make those big plays.
Lakers looking to push. Bryant spinning in the lane. Back for Gasol. Ready pass.
We challenge each other. Fish and I have had a relationship where, you know, when we first got here, and we were the guys that, you know, on back-to-backs would have to go and practice for everybody else. So we wound up playing full court, one-on-one basketball, and almost fighting, literally. From that point forward, I just gained so much respect from him because of his competitiveness and his ability to hit big shots.
Kobe Bryant pulls up. It's good again. Back-to-back jumpers. And the Lakers bring in the lead.
I just hate that this had to happen in order for us to appreciate the full version of Kobe Bryant, not just the athletic greatness, but like the full version of who he.
And appreciate each other.
In Miami, we lost. And after the game, he was so pissed that when he would shoot on the contest, D-Wade was hitting him on the.
I tap him a little bit.
On the wrist, so
just
on the
forearm. Just a little
bit. After the game that night, till 2-3 in the morning, grabs one of our developmental coaches back out on the court in the arena and is telling him to hit him on the arm on purpose while he's shooting because he wanted to try to figure out.
Fish had been struggling. Where did you get the confidence to go to him to pass him the ball in that situation?
Oh, he's been there before. He's been there and done that, you know. And locker room, I was kind of teasing him a little bit because, you know, he's 0-for-5 on three-pointers until he made those last two.
He was an iconic basketball player, but he was one of those few people that transcended the sport he played and became so much more important to so many people. You know, I read a column about him yesterday, and I went back over his own philosophy about how to compete, how to win, how to deal with pain. What was it about Kobe Bryant that made him such a great athlete and such a great person?
No easy points. Make him earn everything.
There wasn't any pain that could stop him. He was always the first one to practice, the last one to leave.
Yo, keep pushing. Keep pushing.
Just his willingness to put in the work at being great.
The Lakers are NBA champions once again. LA wins the 2009 NBA title. Two came in the league at the same time. Two rookies with the LA Lakers. As they've now won their fourth championship together. And for the franchise, the 15th NBA championship. Only the Celtics have more with 17.
The 2009 NBA Finals, Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, Kobe, how is this different from your previous three rings?
I just don't have to hear that criticism, that idiotic criticism anymore. That's the biggest thing.
One, two, three, champion!
Kobe, focus was a word he used to describe you often in these playoffs. Was there a difference between your focus this year and last year? And if so, why the difference?
Well, I was just locked in, just completely locked in. I think it's a matter of understanding the moment. It's also understanding your team and the lead that they have to follow. You know, that's what I tried to do. You know, I was grumpy for a while. Now I'm just ecstatic. You know, I'm like a kid in a candy store right now.
Here we are, the NBA Finals, champions. Back to the hotel, spend time with my family, man.
Where they at?
Spend time with my family. You know, they sacrificed all year for me to do what I do to get to this point. I can't wait just to be with them.
MVP last year, MVP this year.
Kobe, you won the MVP, you led the team to the finals. How do you characterize this season?
Well, I mean, the goal was to win a championship. You know, it wasn't to win MVP or anything like that, it was to win a championship. So, you know, from that aspect, we failed.
When we lost in the finals to the Celtics in 2008, that was a turning point. I had to understand what their journey was. How are they feeling as people? What are they going through? When you have empathy towards your teammates, it helps you communicate better, helps you be a better leader, right? When you have empathy towards your opponents, it helps you destroy them quicker. Seriously, think about it, because you understand exactly who they are, you understand what they've gone through, you understand what buttons to push, you understand if they're insecure, you understand if they fear embarrassment.
Deep in the ocean that I cast away, the innocence is burning in flames, a million miles from home, I'm walking ahead. Frozen to the bone, I am a soldier on my own. I don't know the way. I'm riding up the heights of shame. I'm waiting for the call, the hand on the chest. I'm ready for the fight and fate.
Stuck in my head, the thunder of the drums. The tides, the rhythm of the souls, the number of dead. The rising of the hearts, very head. From the dawn of time to the end of days, I will have to run away. I want to feel the pain and the bitter taste.
Right, to the basket, left hand, and actually, beautiful.
Turnaround shot, block, Pierce. Excellent defensive play. The Celtics turn in one of the great comebacks in NBA playoff history. Down 24 in the second quarter, down 20 in the third. They come back and win game four.
The steady burst of snow is burning my hands, frozen to the bone.
What a performance for the Boston Celtics here in Game 6.
Kobe, a little bit more about the future. This team can get back here next year and maybe win the finals. Or does this team need a shake-up during the offseason?
No, we're fine. I think what we have to do is continue to work. I mean, that's really the key, is understanding that this isn't guaranteed to anybody. I mean, there's people who've gotten here before and never gotten back, so it's important for us to understand that, to work hard, and come back next year ready to go.
You know, a guy who motivated me, who brought the best out of me, you know, on and off the court. And I tell people to today, you know, there would be no Paul Pierce the Truth without Kobe. You know, I felt like I lost a family member. I mean, the impact of this from a guy, and I'm not going to sit here and say I was very close to Kobe, but we had a lot of great moments together on and off the court. He brought the very best out of me. I'll tell you a story. We were shooting a commercial, and, you know, we're casually, me and him are going one-on-one for the camera. Like, okay, let's guys set up, let's shoot the shot of you. Going one-on-one, and I'm casually dribbling, like a walk-around, shoot-around type of thing. And so I'm going through a move, and he pokes the ball away out of my hand, and I'm like, let's get this shot. You know what I mean? Kind of like, but it just turned into a one-on-one battle with both sweating, like a mini, like 2-3 minute one-on-one battle in a commercial shoot. Now, I'll never forget that.
We have had fun with some of the head-to-head altercations that you've had with Ron Artest over the years. And now you're going to be having fun with Ron this year. He hasn't won a chip. You've got four. His drive is going to be relentless all year to get that championship. He said he'd come here and play for nothing. And I just want you to tell me and everybody what it's going to be like now to have Ron as a teammate after battling tooth and nail against him.
Well, it's even more fun in practice. You know what I mean? It's even more so because, you know, we get to do that every single day.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we know what he brings to the table as an individual. Now it's time to mesh that into what we do as a group. And, you know, that's what we're kind of excited about, the possibility of seeing how that develops.
Best of luck this upcoming season.
Thank you.
I know you want that repeat like nothing else in your life. So go get it, and we're going to have fun watching you all year, my man.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
I won a championship playing against him. He beat us in the championship, and just to get that revenge. He wanted that revenge so bad. He worked after that season. They won the next year, but I don't know if it felt the same as beating us.
No,
it didn't feel right beating Orlando.
I can tell you for sure.
It was like everything he ever wanted out of all the championships, and he got us, and that one hurts to today.
He told us on the podcast that was one of the hardest moments in his life, the 2008 loss to you guys.
Yeah,
was one of the hardest moments in his life.
Hard. I mean, I never seen him cry, and I saw him cry, and I was like, we got to be ready for next year.
He's going to come back. He's coming.
I think he's the best player in our league right now. What he's able to do offensively and defensively is unbelievable, and I look up to a guy like Kobe Bryant just because of what he's able to do every night he goes out on the basketball court.
Best clutch shooter in today's game, I would have to go with Kobe Jelly Bean Bryant.
He's got the pick, he's got the pop, the three, yes!
Breaks right by Rush and over the shoulder, a beauty, and one. Look, heading to the line, looking for the three-point play. Another incredible one.
Yeah, and if I'm ever at the crossroads and start feeling mixed signals like Morse code, my soul start to grow colder than the North Pole. I try to focus on the hole of where the torch goes.
No way, then what else? Oh, I couldn't believe that, man. That's a great stuff.
Lord knows I waited for this a lifetime, and I'm an icon.
Kobe is the hardest working, you know, the most committed basketball player the game has ever seen. Every day of the year, Kobe Bryant is doing something to make himself a better basketball player.
Fuel to the flame that I train with and travel with. Something in my eyes say I'm so close to having a prize. I realize I'm supposed to reach for the sky.
Unbelievable. Reverse layup.
One game, one desire, one flame, one bonfire, let it burn higher. I never show signs of fatigue or turn tired, cause I'm the definition of tragedy turned triumph. It's David and Goliath.
Bryant hits it as the shot clock expires.
Feeling sore like they fed me to the lions, before my time start to wind down like the Mayans. I show them how I run down like a science. It sounds like a riot on hush, it's so quiet, the only thing I hear is my heart. I'm inspired by the challenge that I find myself standing eye to eye with. The move like a wise warrior and not a coward. You can't escape the history that you was meant to make. That's why the highest victory is what I meant to take. You came to celebrate, I came to celebrate. I hate losing, I refuse to make the same mistakes.
What a clutch shot once again from Kobe Bryant.
What we do, baby?
Yes, sir.
What we do?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, man, you know it.
That's why they call you the greatest. They don't believe us, man. You're going to make them believe us, man.
My man.
You're going to make them believe us. Every time.
Mm-hmm.
Boom, 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 boom. I'm gonna shoot you right down, right off of your feet. Boom, 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 boom.
What can you say about Kobe? I don't know if there's words to...
Durant, blocked by Bryant. Wire to wire victory for Kobe Bryant and his team.
I don't know if he's hurt, I don't know if he's tired, but he's not Kobe.
Kobe is looking old and tired. He played way too many minutes, thanks to Phil Jackson.
They defended their home court, now it's our turn. Simple as that.
How much trouble right now is Kobe Bryant and the Lakers
in? You can't stop Kevin Durant. They can't stop Russell Westbrook. Where is Kobe? He hadn't gone over 25 points. Where is he?
Bang, bang, bang. Knock it off.
Kobe, baseline, fall away. No. Gasol, yes, on the follow.
At this time right now, he's the best player in basketball, and I don't think it's even close.
Bang, 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 bang.
1 second. Kobe Bryant gets the basket.
Take it home with me. I'm gonna shoot you right now.
Pitch to Fish, a deep three. He knocked it down.
Here is Bryant, yes. The Lakers advance for the Western Conference Finals.
What made Kobe Bryant so special?
His mindset.
Bryant, out the floor.
He had a determination. It wasn't far off of that's who he was.
Bryant, and comes up short on two.
Every one of those plays, that was great defense. That's what's scary.
Bang, 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 bang.
What a shot by Kobe Bryant. That's unguardable.
I'm gonna shoot you right now.
Shot clock now to five. What a shot. I mean, you can't defend that. Are you kidding me?
Some of the down moments for you in basketball?
Well, losing to the Celtics in the finals of 2008, I mean, that was tough.
It's a great challenge for us to see how much we've improved, how much we've gotten better. You know, win a championship is a failure. I mean, it's simple as that.
Hero villain is a simple philosophy of how do you channel the villain to unleash the hero? How do you use darkness to create greatness?
I've seen us as a team grow so much from 2008. We just accomplished this amazing thing. I couldn't be any more proud.
If you want to make history, you have to do historic things.
A lot has been made about Kobe's motivations in the big picture. Do you feel that he really wants to catch Magic and eventually Michael with championships?
It's not at the front of his mind. It's about his personality. It's about winning. He was very concerned about his mortality and how history is going to look at him. I don't think it's in the back of his mind that he has to catch Magic or he has to catch Michael or anything else. He wants to win.
You know, when you're in this culture, in our society, you can do some phenomenal things individually, but they'll never reach their full potential unless you do them collectively.
As we're set for game one, the 2010 NBA Finals, Lakers and the Celtics. It just sounds right at this time of year. And the crowd on its feet at the Staples Center, they've been fired up. You like that expression, feel the love. With the fans in this series, it's feel the hate. Pearson Artest already grappling. It took 27 seconds for these two to go at it a bit. Allen on Kobe Bryant down this end.
Talk about the impact you had getting their guys in foul trouble.
Yeah, I mean, just being aggressive and you know, getting the bodies, and tonight I got the benefit of the whistle.
Easily, this is the Eric Gasol right there for the team. And fake clock by Rasheed Wallace. which is absolutely nothing you can do.
A touch on that type of shot, that's very difficult.
Oh, blocked by Bryant. It's Gasol running the floor.
You got to come aggressively right to the elbow. I mean, right now.
Shot clock at 8. Gasol to the go. Gasol finds move inside, slowly having a strong all-around game.
You know, Mike, the difference with Kobe Bryant and every other player in the world is his mentality. You take a look, Chris Rock sitting right next to Kobe Bryant, shooting the breeze, funniest man in the world, telling jokes, and take a look at Kobe Bryant. I don't even hear you. I'm on a mission.
Fisher alley up to Bryant.
Bryant does a great job for us, you know, setting the tone, you know, defensively with his intensity and with his energy. This gave us a physical presence.
The Celtics lose game one on the road here at the Staples Center. A terrific performance in game one for the Lakers. Let's see what the Celtics have here in game two. Bryant, nice pass to Bynum. Fisher lobs it in to Bynum. Bynum, very active early. Now he fires a three, knocks it down. Hey, Allen has the highest three-point percentage in NBA Finals history. Allen steps back. Gets another. Back for Allen, a three. It's good. Ray Allen from downtown. And the Celtics open up a 10-point lead. Rondo. Oh, what a fake! And he lays it in. Pretty play from Rajon Rondo. Ray Allen backs out, a three. Knocks it down again. Ray Allen from downtown. He's 4 for 4. Allen. Bang!
Nice.
5 for 5 from downtown.
And now Kobe Bryant stepping up to take the challenge of trying to give him no space.
Allen, again, another three.
Once again, you leave his body, that's all he wants.
Ray Allen, another three. Puts it in. 7 for 7 from downtown. Gasol inside. Count it out, a foul. What a finish from Gasol. Stolen by Bryant. Bad pass. Puts up the three. Scores 7 straight points to cut it to 6. Huge switch in momentum to end the first half. Our test for 3. And just like that, it's a 2-point game. Bryant to the basket, lays it in. 1-point game. Now the Lakers with a chance to take the lead. They do. Rondo has to put it up. Knocks it down. A 3-pointer for Rondo. Gasol, nice pass to Bynum once again with a perfect feed. Rondo, a clear path to the basket. Bryant back in. Allen on him. Bryant to drive. Hesitation. Up and under. Counter. Foul. It has been a hard-fought physical game. Back out to Allen for 3. Puts it in. And that's an NBA Finals record. Most threes in a Finals game. His 8th. Gasol. His 6th block. Rondo gets it back and puts it in. Fisher. Fisher fakes. Sets. Block from behind. Rondo sets for the jump shot. Knocks it down. And that's going to do it. The Celtics are going to tie this series at 1 apiece.
Garnett at
He's got two in the first minute. Again, Rondo pushing up the floor. Alley-oop to Garnett again. Garnett back to Rondo.
Most impressive is not just about the head coach's voice. Sometimes you have to have troops that deliver your message. Bryant dictating, making the proper adjustments. That's getting it done from a leadership standpoint.
Kobe Bryant and a foul. Odom. Odom on the drive, gets inside, and a foul. In the first two games, he had more fouls than points. He had more fouls than rebounds. Inside. Tony Allen on Bryant. Bryant to the basket, banks it in, and a foul. Good aggressive move from Kobe Bryant. He's got 9 points, and it's a double-figure lead for L.A. Nice bounce pass to Odom, and Odom gets it to go. 15-point Laker lead. Rondo right to the basket. Pass from Bryant. Gasol the finish. Gonna add. Bryant can't get it to fall. Bynum trying to keep it alive. Bryant takes it away from Garnett. Finds Bynum inside. Counted out a foul. Great hustle play from Kobe Bryant. He is still not easy to play with sometimes from the standpoint of he can be very rough and difficult on his teammates.
Which is good. He's an all-time great competitor. He's an all-time great player. And he's going to make me better.
And gets away from Rondo. Oh, what a pretty move. Left-handed floats it in. Here's jump shot. That's a three. Celtic fans starting to come alive. Their team down by as many as 17. Have cut it to five. Great reaction by Kobe Bryant. Fisher to the basket. Oh, tough drive from Derek Fisher. Bryant, the three. Puts it in.
Those are the shots that hurt you.
Fisher, again, banks it in. Good defense from Artest, and it's Laker ball. Fisher to the basket, gets hammered, and he puts it in. Derek Fisher hard to the basket.
The heart and soul of this team. Simple as that.
This is what you do. You want to win championships, you got to make plays. And, you know, we make plays. It's one game.
Boston Celtics losing at home in game three. Now down 2-1. They know the importance of tonight. They've bounced back so many times during the regular season and again during the playoffs. And a huge game tonight. Do not want to go down 3-1 in this series. Crowd fired up again, but you can almost feel a little different. They're a little anxious after what they watched the other night. Allen is on Kobe Bryant. Tough shot. Gets it to go. Rondo, nice pass inside to Pierce. Pierce gets it to go. Gasol. Pierce gets it inside. Bynum banks it in. Garnett with a beautiful pass, and Pierce off to the start they wanted. He's 3 for 3. Bryant, tough shot, banks it in. Pierce fakes, nice move on Artest. Gets it to go.
All Pierce has started off on fire, and the ball hasn't found
it. Rondo, nice move, gets to the basket, banks it in. Crowd applauding the physical play. Robinson sets, puts up the three, puts it in. Farmar open and hits a three-pointer. Nice feed to Davis inside. Davis banks it in again and a foul. Shannon Brown the drive. Tough four-way shot. Oh, gets it to go. Kobe Bryant drills the three-pointer. The Lakers have a three-point lead. Pierce. Oh, tough shot to Pierce to bank it in. Oh, Bryant back-to-back threes.
Bryant knocks in his third straight jumper.
Gasol back to Odom, and the finish with a foul. Perkins, the offensive rebound, is put back. Celtics tough on the offensive glass so far tonight. Allen blocked by Gasol. Garnett picks it up, puts up the shot, puts it in at the buzzer. With the steal, then releases down the other end. defense turning offense for Boston. Fisher tried to draw the foul. He threw it in. Gasol. And the lead back up to five again. Ray Allen inside to Garnett. Gets it to Perkins. Lays it in. Crowd has come alive. They've been quiet. Ahead to Garnett. 1-point game. Spins house. Lakers lost the lead. Celtics go up by one. The momentum has shifted. Shot clock down to five. Bryant drills the three-pointer.
That's not fair. I mean, that's a big-time, tough shot.
Tries it again. Does it again. Back-to-back threes for Kobe Bryant. And the Lakers go up by four. Davis spin move. Reverse. Banks it in. Tie game. Robinson inside. Puts it in. Davis the rebound. Banks it in. And a foul. Pierce to the basket. Drive, kicks it up top, stolen by Rondo. Rondo with the lay-in.
Everything's been not choreographed, but it's been practiced so many times that it's second just, nature.
There's why reinvent it? Like I don't understand that. You go out and play the game, and you're just trying to create something new. No. This is what I do. This is what I do extremely well. You're going to have to stop me from doing that. And if you do stop me from doing that, I have a counter to that.
It is a raucous TD Garden. What is the final home game of the season for the Boston Celtics?
The reason why I loved that series so much is that we went down 3-2. We're sitting in the locker room, and it's really, really quiet. I'm sitting there looking around, and we just lost the Celtics in 08, so this is like revenge, right? And they're kicking our butt again, right? So I sit around, and I just start laughing. I said, man, listen, if we start this season, and all you have to do is win 2 games at home, and you're NBA champ, would you take that? We'll take care of the first game, and I promise you, they're not winning Game 7 on our home floor. It's not happening. Thank you.
great home team. So, it's confident.
Organize your offense and move the ball and trust yourself. Share the basketball.
If you want it, you gotta believe.
And the Lakers in unfamiliar territory, trailing a series for the first time in these 2010 playoffs. Bryant gets inside.
Riding on the scraping star. We gotta stand up.
Another good open look from Test. Gets that to go.
If you want it, you got it. You gotta believe.
Kobe Bryant, the jump shot.
Believe in yourself.
Bryant drills the jumper with a hand in his face.
Cause it's all just a game. We just wanna be loved.
Tried to jam it in. Ball goes right back to him. And Bryant on the putback. Another steal on a bad pass. Bryant ahead to Gasol. Strides down the lane. Lakers have scored 8 straight.
As Bryant takes another three.
Williams just in the game. Knocks down a 2-pointer. Hold him ahead to Farmar. Farmar inside. Oh, what a finish. 20-point lead for the Lakers. Crowd on its feet, chanting defense, and the defense has been superb. Lakers have continually said, though, they're a different team than 08. Tonight is their chance to prove it. Artest steps back, hits a two.
He's not waiting for Kobe Bryant to make a play and find him.
Bryant on a drive, gives the contact, count it, and a foul.
His drive and energy night after night is just unmatched. How hard he plays every single night.
Bryant for Brown.
26 for Bryant, but he had plenty of help tonight.
Jordan Brown! Wow!
My goodness. And Bryant's going to get a huge ovation here. Kobe Bryant and the Lakers do what they had to do. Get one win and get another game.
Oh, no. No, no. Na 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 na.
Rest now.
Hold on.
Na, 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 na,
thank you.
Right.
All together. 1, 2, 3.
Red.
I remember we wanted it so bad. And as a team, we struggled early. We didn't shoot the ball well. And finally, in that fourth quarter, we were able to get it together. I knocked down a shot, you knocked down a shot. Early on, what were you thinking? How were you feeling about the struggle?
It was just like, every time we got close, you know, kept slipping away from us. It's just like, no, we have to do it. And I remember we had a conversation in the timeout towards the end of the game when we finally got to that door again. It was like, oh, now is the time. Now it's time we go through that door. And you hit that big three, you know, I hit a little pull up too, and you know, Ron obviously made that huge shot. Yeah. You know, Sasha came in and fixed the hair and knocked down a couple clutch free throws, and then the rest is history.
You know, they talk about great game, big games, great players make big plays. Is there any enjoying the moment?
You can't really enjoy the moment when you're in it. You just got a job to do, you go out there and you do it. And then you can look back on it.
What time is it, kids?
It's a moment and a game that kids dream about as they're growing up, learning the game of basketball. Celtics trying to bounce back from a poor performance. Bryant trying for his fifth NBA championship. He was so disappointed with the way it finished, obviously, in 2008 at game 6. Rondo inside and gets the banker. Blocked by Wallace. And Gasol with an excellent second effort. Rondo's transition game so vital. Phil Jackson said that's the number one key for them. Now
Again, good defense on Bryant. Double teamed by Pierce.
Well, you see the mindset of the Celtics. They're not allowing Bryant to take over this game early on.
Gasol blocked. Garnett got a piece of it. Rondo to Garnett. Perfect pass. And Boston up by four. Both teams playing what you would expect. Tenacious defense. Great one for Allen's doing a great job chasing his play, Kobe Bryant. Artest with the steal. Drives down, lays it in. Bryant nearly falls, gets back up, one on the shot clock, puts it up. And he grazes the rim, Artest the rebound. Lakers shooting 28% from the field, and the game is tied. Wallace five on the shot clock. Turns and shoots and banks it in. Celtics have done an excellent job defensively on Kobe Bryant as they shoot 26% from the field. Both Bryant and Gasol struggling big time shooting the basketball. Well, with 24 minutes to go, the NBA championship still very much up for grabs. A shot from Rondo and gets it to go. The Celtics with the largest lead of the night causes Phil Jackson to call timeout.
When you knocked down the pull-up two, I knew we had it locked at that moment.
Dude, and you know what, man? I've been playing like crap all night long. Least I could do is make one shot. I just got to make one.
Nice pass inside. Garnett gets it to go.
You're a Michael Jordan stan. If a player today took 49 shots in the NBA Finals game and their team lost, what would you say? Just think about it.
He's got to find a way to get better quality shots.
Offensive rebound, goes back up and banks it in, and it's a 13-point lead.
At the end of the day, our goal and our mission is to win championships, period.
Gasol, nice spin move using the left hand. So impressive, a man that size with such skill with the basketball. And go, tipped by Olaf, gets it back and puts it up and in. A big bucket for the Lakers that cut it to four.
And you got to give credit to Bryant. Struggling all game long. This has been a bad game for him offensively. But the guy has 12 big rebounds. He's doing his job defensively and on the board.
Bryant blows past. Oh, he blocked it!
When you have your star player who is the first one at the gym and the last one to leave.
Spins, fakes, shot. It's good!
It sets the bar for everybody else. I don't think people really gets the credit for the amount of work that he puts in because he made it look effortless.
Fisher for three. Bang!
That's what made the Lakers great.
I made a promise to myself. The most important thing for me is to get better every single day.
Bryant on the pull-up. Punch it in.
And if I lived that way, then over time, you know, I'd have something that was beautiful.
Bryant looking. Test. That's a three. Bang! Oh, blocked free throws from Sasha Berjic.
Hero villain is a simple philosophy of how do you channel the villain to unleash the hero? How do you use darkness to create greatness?
Rondo fakes, dribbles, puts up the three. Won't go. Rebound to Saul. Kicks it out to Odom. Odom throws it ahead. Repeat back-to-back titles. The LA Lakers, the 2010 NBA champions.
My name is Kobe Bryant. I'm 17 years old. I have a big decision coming up, and that's whether or not go to college or straight to the NBA.
No, I have decided to skip college and take my talent to the NBA.
Kobe Bryant, at 18 years, 2 months, and 8 days old, became the youngest ever to play in the NBA for his childhood favorite team, the Lakers.